offer.
2 minutes of television wow that makes you buy now.
But I'm still not done.
Direct response ads are a multi-billion dollar industry.
Billy Mays here for OxyClean.
Billy Mays.
Hi, Billy Mays here.
And Anthony Sullivan.
Anthony Sullivan hip.
Our pitchman.
You're making too much money. We have to lower your rate.
Two guys.
But wait, there's more!
With the A-game and national fame.
Best pitchman.
These two veteran pitch pros have mastered the art of turning good ideas into must-have products. Now, they're putting their egos aside and their heads together.
You don't want to talk to me?
I see you, but I don't hear you. It's great.
They're going to help everyday people with great ideas go from rags to riches.
This is a home run.
And maybe turn someone's million-dollar dream into a reality.
Your dreams come true.
But you have to watch now.
Here's how to order.
On this episode of Pitchman, an inventor creates what he hopes is a life-saving device to repel shark attacks.
I'm a little nervous.
But the only way to test it is for Sully to swim with the big fishes.
Come on, Sully!
And Billy doesn't make it easy. And this man invents another life-saving device for a cell phone.
Hi, Billy Mays here for the Jupiter Jack.
But Billy's in a mood, and it's spoiling the shoot.
Your high-maintenance talent is what you are.
You know what? You suck.
It all starts with the pitch. Someone has an idea and wants to sell it to the world.
My product is called the Pit Boss Barbecue. And you're gonna lay it down on its side and simply open it up.
Sometimes their inventions are designed to make life easier.
It's called the Spearhead Spade. And this shape, along with the several cutting surfaces here, allow it to cut into the dirt very easily.
My partners and I have invented this, a utility box and package opening tool called the Clever Cutter. Can't cut yourself, can't damage the product inside the box. And there you are.
And sometimes their inventions come from a desire to save lives.
I'm from Huntington, Long Island, New York, and I'm an inventor of this product called Sharkstopper. It's an acoustic repellent that repels sharks away from humans in water activities.
One of these inventions has captured the imagination of Billy and Sully. It's the Sharkstopper, and inventor Brian Wynn has been invited to Sullivan Productions to pitch his invention.
Hey, Brian. Hi, guys.
How are you?
How are you?
Great to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice
Anthony
Sullivan,
how are you?
Nice to meet you.
I grew up on the water surfing. I love to windsurf. I'm a water baby. And bottom line is the Sharkstopper, if it does work, could really be a lifesaver.
I came in from Long Island, New York.
Yeah.
And the company I started is called Sharkstopper LLC. My first product that we're going to introduce this year is called the personal shark repellent. An adult or a child would wear this on their ankle. How it works, it emits an acoustical signal. And it deters the sharks, keeps them away. Probably around 20 yards of omnidirectional protection.
Proven? You have
proven.
Facts?
Yes. Yeah, I have facts. I tested in the Bahamas. I tested in Mexico. I tested
well,
in...
I mean, when you say test, would you...
I worked
you
with
doctors. In, you jumped into the water with sharks?
I personally didn't. No. No.
Why wouldn't you do it?
I would do it.
If I put that around my foot, like a surfboard leash, that's going to repel a shark.
Yes. This is going to create a noise that they don't like, they're going to be suspect of it, and they're going to go for the next easier target.
You say a noise that they don't like. What is the noise that they don't like?
This is the noise of a killer whale sound.
And what would a killer whale sound like?
It's got a, you got to put this underwater.
Right, or it magnifies it.
Holy, now I'm scared.
Where did you get this sound from?
A lot of testing. There you go.
Okay.
There you go.
Sound travels four times faster in water than it does in air. So when the Sharkstopper hits the water, it self-activates and sends out sound waves that mimic a shark's most feared enemy, the killer whale. Theoretically, this would cause any shark to stay far away from a person wearing the Sharkstopper.
It's a part of killer whales feeding. Now, a shark isn't gonna go, either genetically or their own personal experience. They're not gonna go.
What if it fails?
Ryan has invested a lot of time and money to make the Sharkstopper a hit.
Invested 8 years in this product, a lot of testing in the open waters, Mexico, the Bahamas, Seattle, Hawaii, and different species of sharks. A lot of money, up to 200 grand in this product so far.
With the finished prototype, he's ready to take it to market. If Billy and Sully bite, this could be a huge step for Brian and his shark repellent.
What if it fails?
That's the problem. That's what I'm wearing. I mean, what if somebody's wearing it and they
get it? What if it's defective? I mean,
there's going to be a bar gauge on there to indicate how much battery power you have on it.
I'd like to try it out. I really would like to try it out. Maybe take it down and try it out.
You're nuts.
No.
If I put him in shark-infested waters...
What do you mean shark-infested waters?
Well, you're the swimmer. I mean, I take him down to Egmont Key where there's a lot of sharks, and I put him in the water, they're going to stay away from him.
Yes. I will personally do it. I will put it on and do it.
No, if we do a product, we like to test it ourselves.
Yes.
I tell you, I'm interested because even during the hurricane season when I surf over on the East Coast, you can be sitting there, and even if you see a dolphin fin come up, the first thing that comes to your mind is shark.
Yeah.
Of course.
I don't care who you are. It's on. It's in the back of your
mind
the whole
time. It's in everybody's mind. This is an insurance policy.
Ever since 1976.
You have auto insurance, you have home insurance.
Shark insurance.
Why wouldn't you have shark insurance?
Right. Thanks very much for...
Yes.
Pitching us the product. It seems like a great idea. It really does. I mean, it's a limited audience, but it's something that's close to my heart. So I'm interested in definitely trying it
out. You, brother. Yeah,
I appreciate it, guys.
All right. Thanks very much.
Thank you,
thanks
Billy.
For coming in. I really
thank
appreciate
so
it.
So long. Bye-bye, guys. My feeling is pretty optimistic. I know it's a great product. I know it's a needed product. And I've got my hopes pretty high on this one.
Finally, a product that comes along for you. Yeah. Has your name written all over it. The problem I have with the Sharkstopper, if it doesn't work, you're dead.
Skeptical about the Sharkstopper's ability, Billy and Sully have sent a prototype to renowned shark expert and author of The Secret Life of Sharks, Dr. Peter Klimley, to get his feedback.
Hi, thanks for taking our call today. I found out through some sources that you are the number one go-to guy for knowledge on sharks pretty much in the world. Would that be correct?
Yeah, well, many people believe that. And I've worked, in fact, with acoustics and sharks, so I would be the appropriate person to talk to.
It makes this noise, sort of like...
Yeah, but it's even higher than that. It's kind of a...
And that, I think, is a problem with it. Because
sharks don't hear above 1,000 hertz, 1 kilohertz.
This kind of sound. And so any
repellent, and I worked on this many years ago, is going to be lower frequency.
You know, the idea of an acoustic repellent is a valid idea.
But you have to use the right
frequency. Now, the first experiments that I did
was with a killer whale sound, a killer whale scream. It goes,
and so it changes from
300 to 2,000 hertz.
My friend Anthony Sullivan could be in for a world of hertz if the hertz aren't right.
You bet.
All right.
Let me ask you, if I can convince Billy to
lower him in with the sharks, do you think
that might scare a shark?
It might.
Now, Billy, with his
voice, that would be a good shark repellent.
That is low frequency. It is loud.
Right. You better believe it.
Before we actually make a TV commercial on this product, I want to test it. I'd love you to come down if you have time. Perhaps we can organize your
airfare to come down in the Bahamas and at least
put this to the test.
Well, tell you the truth, you know, I'm not going to because I just think you're trying to sell people snake oil.
Excuse me, I have to stop you right there, Pete, because you know what? Billy Mays does not sell snake oil.
I get offended when someone brings that in.
I humbly apologize.
Billy Mays signing off.
Billy Mays signing off is exactly what would work.
For now, the pitch pros are off to New Jersey to visit Telebrands for their monthly pitch session with AJ Kubani. the godfather of as-seen-on-TV marketing. They'll take pitches from dozens of inventors, hoping to find that next blockbuster project. AJ is one of the toughest guys in the business to impress.
I can judge a product usually within the first few seconds and decide whether it's going to be something that will work in direct response or will not work in direct response.
In order to have great skin, you need to exfoliate, you need to moisturize, and you need to protect from the sun. So what if you make a skin brush, the perfect skin brush, where it's a handheld device similar to this concept, and has three extensions, not just one. The rotating exfoliator, the atomizer for the SPF spray, and then you have a pump for the moisturizer. It's fabulous.
Hey, it's a good idea.
It's a good idea.
I don't know if it's a good idea. We're not the customers, so we have to try and pretend we know what women want. We don't know what the hell women want.
Women like things that are simple, easy, and convenient. I think as men, they had a hard time understanding why women really want this, but I think they need to speak to their wives and their girlfriends, and they'll see that women always want to know, how do I stay young? How do I preserve my youth? And I think it's a great concept.
Thomas Edison invented the single filament light bulb. Well, we invented the double filament light bulb. When one filament burns out, the other one lights up. Think about this. Over 11 billion...
Someone else invented this. I've seen this already.
Next up is Mr. Diaz, who has invented a seatbelt extender designed to improve driving safety.
I was involved in an accident about 2-3 years ago, and I never recovered because I have a damage in my fifth lumbar. I will die with this problem.
You got rear-ended or head-on or just doesn't matter, right? You just twisted like this.
Anytime when the car stops, boom. It's exactly what happens when you twist a piece of chicken or something when you're gonna eat. That is what it creates the problems in the fifth lumbar of the people.
The body gets twisted like a piece of chicken in an accident.
Yes, sir.
Okay, and your product's gonna solve that problem?
Yes. Boom, you are ready to go. That's it, you're good to go.
By moving the connection point to the center of the body, the seat belt acts more like a safety harness and prevents the body from twisting during an accident.
I like the idea.
The guys are going to consider the seatbelt extender, and that makes Mr. Diaz happy for not one, but two reasons.
Number one, because I'm going to help the people. And number two, and maybe very close to number one, because I'm going to make some money.
Hi, good afternoon, John. My
Billy Mays.
Jason Bob.
After a long day of pitches, the guys have only one left. Jason Bob has created a hands-free cell phone device called the Blackjack.
I assume that you three gentlemen all use cell phones.
Yep.
You and 270 million people here in the United States and over 3 billion here in the on this great planet. The device allows you to do something that no other device lets you do. When you plug the unit into the headset jack of your phone and turn it on and turn your radio to 80.7 in the car, it allows you to have a hands-free conversation through the speakers in your car while your voice is picked up by the microphone on the Blackjack. It's a high sensitivity speakerphone microphone, and that way you don't sound like you're a mile away when you talk to it.
Jason Bob lives in Oregon, where he works at Pacific Cellular Supply, a wholesale distributor of cell phone accessories.
I sell lots and lots of Bluetooth products and lots of wired hands-free and fully installed car kits. And there was nothing that was really small and compact that plugged into the headphone jack and made the audio that you would otherwise hear through a headphone or through Bluetooth go through all the speakers in the car.
FM radio technology in a small package is the key to Jason's instant high-fidelity cell phone speaker system. The device plugs into the headphone jack and retransmits the audio to a specific frequency on any car radio, so the driver hears through the car speakers while the driver's audio is picked up by the product's tiny integrated microphone. After years of tinkering with the idea, Jason got special inspiration from a close friend.
A very good friend of mine who was pushing me for years and years to put this product out died of cancer, and one of his last things he asked me to do was to put this product out. And when he died, I made it a focus, and I'm here.
Fulfilling his dying friend's wish, Jason invested his personal savings to design, patent, and create a blackjack prototype. He believes it's worth the risk.
This is my box of joy right here. This is my product. And it's competing with all these big boys. Let's hope it does really good.
There's a couple things going for this, AJ. There's going to be legislation introduced in the next 2 years that's going to ban the use of a hand sanitizer.
30 states already have the legislation.
It's going to go 100% because it's a safety issue. The only thing I don't like about it is, can the person behind you hear your conversation?
No. This has been approved by the FCC, which it has a range of 25 feet.
It's small, it's really easy to understand, it fits any phone, it's universal, and my guess is very inexpensive to manufacture.
This is a winner.
Smell this. Yep. Smells like, what does it smell like?
It smells like money.
Yeah, that's right.
With AJ's connection to manufacturing, this becomes a $10 item and we sell 20 million of them.
I think easily, maybe more than 20 million.
It's a silence.
All right, we like it.
Well, I like it a lot.
Billy, Sully, and AJ are so excited about the blackjack, they offer Jason a deal on the spot. And Jason feels he's a step closer to saving lives and fulfilling his friend's dying request.
He would be so proud and so happy that a great idea, hopefully, is going to be seen by everybody, and it's going to do really well, I think. So, to my friend, thank you.
It's 9:12 a.m. and Sully is running late to meet Billy for a Sharkstopper field test.
Taxi!
Yesterday, Sully was supposed to field test the blackjack on his own, but an old friend flew into town for a visit.
Billy's gonna be a little upset, but I've got an idea, because I always have an idea.
Sully decides to improvise a field test with a cab driver.
Let me see if I can call Billy Mays on this. Tune your radio to 88.7 if you can.
I got it on there.
You do? All right.
But cool. There's a lot of static.
No, so I just turned it on. Billy! You know Billy Mays? You know who he is? He's a really obnoxious guy that yells at the TV the whole time with a beard. Damn, it's almost as bad as this. Unbelievable. Billy, crank the volume a little bit. Keep your eyes on the road. Don't crash. Okay? All right. Hey, Billy, I'm just in a taxi. I'm dropping someone off at the airport, and I'll be right there shortly, all right? It's none of your business who I'm dropping off, all right? Okay? It doesn't matter. I'll be there. The only reason you're Billy Mays is because I'm Anthony Sullivan. All right, if I wasn't me, you wouldn't even be you. You wouldn't even be on television if it wasn't for me. Why are you shouting? Go put your blue shirt on and shout at somebody else, because I don't want to hear it, all right? I'm done. I'm done talking to you, okay? All right, here's how to order.
How'd that go over?
It's Billy, he's complaining.
Isn't it supposed to work through the, the whole point to get a phone call?
I know. Okay, let me try again. I'm a little concerned about this product right now. Where's the aerial? In England, we call it an aerial.
It's probably built into the windshield or up here on the roof or something.
Let's try and get it to work, 88.7. This is awesome, this product.
Yes. I would totally use it.
Yeah, I mean, you would, right? So out of 10, how do you rate this product?
No. Zero.
Okay. All right, I got some work.
If you get it working,
well, I like, honestly, I got you. I think there's something wrong with your radio.
Even though the focus group for the blackjack was a disaster,
marry me.
Sully isn't convinced the technical difficulties lie with Jason's product. He'll need to do more testing for a definite result. But that will have to wait.
Billy, I'm on my way, buddy. Please stop calling me, all right?
Sully is late meeting up with Billy for the most dangerous field test yet. The Sharkstopper.
We're ready to go. In fact, we're going to go where some sharks are and see if this product actually works.
My whole family's in town from England. We've got the watchful eye of my mom. My dad's on board. I'm feeling good. I've been training. So my plan of attack is to put this on and haul ass, as you would say in America, as fast as I can to the beach. This is the noise this thing makes. Good. This is supposed to scare sharks away.
I think it's ready. I think we're ready to go.
You feel activated?
Activated by the water that you and I swim in.
Sully is going to swim a mile through shark-infested waters. If Brian's invention works, the sharks will stay away, and Sully will make it to shore in one piece. But Billy isn't going to make it easy.
We got a little surprise for Sully today. We're actually going to be in the other boat, and we're going to be chumming in the waters because he's my best chum. Before he gets in the water, I want to just start chumming the water.
You want to chum all that?
Yeah, all that.
You know, that's where the bull sharks are, and yeah.
Big shark.
Oh yeah, no, that's the stuff that eats your legs. They caught a 900-pound bull shark there.
What would happen if he saw a 900-pound bull shark?
He'd walk on water.
Tell Billy I'm just gonna go in a minute.
That's a nice shark cocktail right there.
For you, Sal.
Put a big scoop of blood in right now. Bloody it up.
We're right here?
Yep. Oh, nice.
I'm a little nervous.
Bull sharks, hammerheads, black tips, reef sharks, you name it. All the big ones. I would not get in the water right now.
Hurry up, Sully!
That's grinded up fish guts.
Oh, nice.
Nice and bloody. Caught a 600-pound bull shark in the shipping channel here, so.
600-pound?
Yeah. Nice.
I'm a little nervous. I'm a little trepidant. I can't see anything through these goggles.
I sure hope that thing works.
You ready? Walking.
Come on, Sully! We're gonna attract some sharks, aren't we?
Yeah, but we usually don't do it when we have a swimmer in the water.
Yeah, but he's got the shark stopper on.
Sully's in the water, he's swimming ashore, while Billy, a good friend of his, is chumming ahead of him. So basically, Sully's swimming into the sea of blood. You know, dunna. Dun, 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 dun.
You got all that blood in the water? You guys are business partners, right? You have life insurance on them?
Oh, yeah.
I reckon he could outswim any shark that's in the sea at this moment in time.
Uh-oh. I think I saw a shark. Sully, swim quick!
Dude! What the f*** are you doing? You're out of your mind!
Come on, Sully!
You really love this guy, huh?
No.
Yeah, keep throwing the blood then.
For you, Sal.
You ready?
Uh-oh. I think I saw a shark. Hurry up, Sully! Holy crap, there's some sharks out there. That'll do it. I hope he's not mad.
Even though Sully made it to shore safely, he's starting to think the shark stopper might not be such a great idea.
Well, I made it, so obviously it was... But I was a little freaked out for a minute. I mean, anytime I think you're in the water and there's just a thought of sharks, it just starts playing mind games with you a little bit. It came off. I was going to turn back and get it, and I'm so close to the shore. Do you really entrust your life to this thing? It's really difficult to prove a negative. And the only real way to see if this product works is if someone actually gets hurt. And in good conscience, you know, the last thing I want is for someone to get hurt using a product, especially in a shark attack. So it's probably not a good product for a TV spot.
After an admittedly not very scientific field test, Sully has decided to cut bait with the shark stopper. Next up, a reckoning with Billy.
I'm not all right. If I could throw this at you, I would right now if it wasn't Jeffrey's bow. I don't appreciate what you just did.
Well, wait a minute. It wasn't just me.
I don't appreciate it.
Hey, I had nothing to do with it.
Wait a minute.
Your idea. I was just driving the boat.
You thought you were supposed to be my friends. No, I don't appreciate it.
Listen. Are you all right? Hey, we wanted to see if the product worked,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I see that. You want to go swim with the sharks?
Oh, you were swimming with the sharks.
Yeah, I know. I just
found out
what you did.
I don't
see it.
all you.
It worked.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think it's a good idea.
Put it on. It's all you. You go for a swim.
Look,
I'll chum. See how you like it. See how you like it, buddy. You're a landlubber. Okay? I grew up on you. You got no respect. Well, with friends like you, I don't need enemies.
I'm sorry, man. I didn't try to hurt you.
You didn't try to hurt me?
No.
You're chumming while I'm swimming.
But we're still chums,
that's
right?
A nice touch.
We still chums?
I'm sorry, man.
Billy thinks he's really clever. He actually thinks in his beady little brain that he can put one over on me, but it's completely pointless. I will always come out on top. That's just the natural order of things.
Sully.
No.
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 No. No. Sully.
Yeah.
Look at a great white.
Hey.
Billy May.
Still my chum? All right.
For inventor Brian Wynn, the news that Billy and Sully are passing does not deter his confidence. While the Sharkstopper may not be a good fit for direct response, he knows there is a market for it, and he's determined to seek it out.
The product will continue. I know there's a need for it, and I still plan to release this year the anchor repellent, personal shark repellent.
For Sully, it's back to square one, trying to salvage their other project, Jason's Blackjack.
My first crack at the blackjack was a complete disaster. Things have got to get better from here, otherwise we're in big trouble.
So this actually connects your phone to your radio. If you turn it up just a little bit.
Let's try my office. That's pretty good.
Yes, it is.
Hey, Arwen.
It's Carla.
Hey, Carla, how are you? How's your weekend? Can you hear me pretty good?
Yeah, pretty good.
Say hi to John, the cab driver. He's on speakerphone as well.
Hi, John.
Hi, how you doing?
Hi. Must not be the TV radio, doesn't it?
Go for John.
Sure beats having a cell phone to mess around with and hold to your ear.
No, it's good right now. I mean, I've got it like 2 feet from me, and we hear you really good on the stereo here.
That's excellent.
Turn the volume up if you can, a little bit. See if we get a signal. There it is. So it's just this little red thing right here. You turn it on, tune it to 88.7.
Yep. I don't like trying to talk on the phone and write and drive. It doesn't work.
You hear the signal's pretty good, right?
Yeah, it sounds good.
What would you expect to pay for something like this if it was for sale?
I have no idea.
Give me a guess.
$50?
That's interesting.
If you got your hands free and your eyes free and you can listen and figure out what's going on, then that's 90% of the battle out here. I'd give it a 10.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Keep the change and keep that, and happy travels, all right, and be safe.
All right, buddy.
Thank you very, very much.
A successful field test has restored Sully's confidence and enthusiasm in the blackjack.
Take care, my man.
So Billy and Sully fast-track it. And less than a week after making a deal in the room, cameras are ready to roll on Jason's invention.
Finished. Perfection.
But there's a problem. Just moments before the first shot of the day, word comes back from the legal department that the copyright application for the blackjack has been denied.
The first order of business is definitely figuring the name out. Jason had the name Blackjack on his packaging. He had great artwork. He had us very excited, and we just assumed that he had the name cleared. Well, it turns out he doesn't have the name cleared.
When I called it the Blackjack, it made all kinds of sense. It's black. It's a jack that plugs into the phone. Blackjack. Unfortunately, there's so many other things out there named Blackjack that it's not trademarkable.
With a crew on the clock and money being spent, Billy and Sully must come up with an alternative name on the fly.
You think it would be pretty simple to come up with a name for a product like this? I probably came up with about 400 names, of which nobody liked any of them.
I like Go Jack. I like Phone Free Jack. I like Freedom Jack.
I came up with Freedom Jack as the first name.
I like that the best.
It's nice. It's an all-American freedom.
Freedom, is it made in America?
It's a cell phone device. It's got nothing to do with freedom. I mean, other than it gives you the freedom to drive.
Freedom Jack gives you the freedom to speak whenever you're driving. It gives you the confidence when you're with your family that you're not going to have a wreck. Or you want to get a cellmate.
What's your First Amendment right now to talk on the phone in a car? Billy's got caught up in this First Amendment thing right now, and it's really not a political product. I like Juno Jack, and I like Jupiter Jack.
Oh, Let's go with Freedom Jack and let's go with Juno Jack.
Thank you.
Oh, Juno Jack.
Just do it.
No, do
I'm something. The producer. I'll call a rap now.
Call rap now.
I'll rap it now and I'll do the show.
Juno
Jack.
What does that mean? What does it mean?
It means nothing. It means nothing.
Go Jack means go Jack.
I don't think a BlackBerry has anything to do with a phone. I don't think an Apple has anything to do with a computer, and a Juno has nothing to do with what we're doing. It just sounds catchy. So I like the name Juno Jack, and I'm gonna make Billy give me Juno Jack, period.
Aaron, you know what I think of that?
What?
Huh?
Crap.
Aaron.
You think it's crap, right?
Kill, you know what I think of that?
Yeah.
Right here.
Why do I have to work? Why do I have to put up with this abuse?
At least I wore black. I'll read it to, you know, any name they want. Phone Free Jack, Freedom Jack, Juno Jack, I Don't Know Jack, What's Up Jack, Jack and Jill, Went Up the Hill. Whatever they want me to read, I'll read. Oh, there goes my phone. Freedom! Oh.
Back in Oregon, inventor Jason Bob hears from Sully about the two alternative names they're using.
Okay. Either one works for me.
And he's still convinced he's got a hit on his hands.
I think you could, honestly, you could call it whatever you want. I think if Billy Mays is pitching it, you could call it anything, and it's going to sell well.
Hi, Billy Mays here for the Freedom Jack, the most convenient hands-free device for any cell phone, guaranteed.
Billy, save it.
The most convenient hands-free device for any cell phone.
Save your pipes. Save your pipes.
No, I got to warm up my pipe.
Save your pipes, buddy.
Dude.
We got a long day. Go off. I got a trailer. I got the Hudson. Go for Grady. Let's pull out, please. Let's go. Roll tape. 20 miles an hour. Maintain 20. And breathe.
It's too loud, Sol.
No, it's not. Okay, we're gonna roll on one. Okay, Billy, and action.
Hi, Billy Mays.
Ready, and back to one. Freedom Jack.
Hi, Billy Mays.
3, 2, 1, action.
Hi.
Billy's got some like squeaky voice thing going on today. I don't know what that's about. He didn't mention that he was sick or anything like that, but his voice keeps cracking, you know? He kind of sounds like, yeah, he's going through puberty or something.
Just relax, because you're losing your voice.
No, I'm not.
I'm hearing it.
Sully, I need to keep doing it to get my voice. Let's go.
Okay, we can't roll, Billy. Sit tight.
Sully wouldn't let me warm up. He's going, take a break, rest your voice. No, rev it up. Get it warmed up. You play around with my voice, it's very sensitive, you know, it needs to warm up. It's like a Ferrari.
Well, we got through one line so far.
It turns out Billy's cracking voice is the least of their problems. Word comes back from the legal department that neither Freedom Jack nor Juno Jack is available. Now they'll have to start from scratch with no name.
The Thingamy Jack.
I need a name. We're in
the whatever Jack.
The Thingamy Jack.
I need
a name. Want to know if we should just read everything with Black Jack? Then at least he can say something and get through the lines, and we can always replace an audio post.
Why don't we have a name? Use a name now that we can actually use.
We got no names. No, we got no names.
Well, why use Blackjack if we can't use it? Don't make me come up there.
We're gonna just keep doing it with no name for now, and then we're gonna stop, take a little break, have some lunch, and we're gonna find a name, and we're gonna do what we can do, all right? So pretty much everything we shot is a complete waste of time so far. I got Billy going out of his mind down here. It's hot. We've got traffic behind us.
It's tough when you don't have a name, Raj.
I understand, Billy, but it's getting upset.
Gatorade or water?
No, I'm good. No, but I'm just saying, there's a whole team of people working on it.
I understand what you're saying.
Oh, no, but I'm sitting here not moving, working with a product with no name. I want one last shot, one last pass.
It's fine.
The pipes are working right now.
One last pass.
So do the right thing. Be safe, not sorry.
One last pass.
Get my system for you and your family.
We just have to wait for the officer. Okay.
We're doing it.
Don't worry, son.
Lunch is sitting there getting cold.
I don't care.
Everyone's tired and
everyone's pissed. Lunch is overrated. If I had it my way, we wouldn't do lunch.
What about, maybe some people want to pee?
Well, you know what?
There's women on the crew. It's not just about you.
There's diapers.
It's all about you, Billy. You have high maintenance talent.
I'm what?
Your high maintenance talent is what you are.
You know what? You suck.
Billy and Sully are running out of daylight, and they've got Jack.
We seem to have blocked up a whole of a main Florida thoroughfare. I don't know, it's one of those days.
We got traffic. I'm blocking up traffic here for our commercial.
You gotta give me something. Billy's going out of his mind. I got the trailer here, I got crew, I got the whole thing. It's a lot more difficult than it sounds. Jupiter Jack. Jupiter Jack, you give me your word. We're gonna go with Jupiter Jack and that's what we're going with. Okay, I'm not changing, I'm not turning back now. Okay, Jupiter Jack it is. Guess it's Jupiter Jack.
Finally got the name, Jupiter Jack. I tell you, I'm so excited. Put the seatbelt on, I'm already revving up the engine. Drive the bus, Sully. Drive the bus.
Here we go.
Drive the bus, Sully. Do your job, I'll do mine.
I would be so pissed off if I was behind us right now.
Product is right here on my phone.
Action.
Hi, Billy Mays here for the Jupiter Jack. The most convenient hands-free device for any cell phone, guaranteed. Jupiter Jack is the only system I use because I could drive safely and talk at the same time.
Just pay separate shipping and handling.
Just pay separate shipping and handling.
Just pay separate shipping and processing.
Just pay separate processing and handling.
Dude, just pay on the lead-ins to the price.
Just pay shipping and
just
processing.
Pay what?
Just pay $14.99. Just pay. Have them do just pay in front of
me. Just pay, all right, ready?
Just pay $14.99.
Just pay $19.99.
Just pay $19.99.
I think we got it.
When it's all over, we hug, we kiss, we make up. Not that we ever had anything going, it's just how we work, how we get things done.
A week after shooting the Jupiter Jack spot, it's time for Sully to check on the edit.
Fire it up, Sarah. Fire in the hole.
Sir, yes, sir.
Hi, Billy Mays here for the Jupiter Jack, the most convenient hands-free device for any cell phone. Guaranteed. Hi, it's Billy.
Sully spots a problem with the commercial.
I mean, can you tell he's not driving? He's kind of not paying attention. He's not paying attention to the road at all.
Not a lot.
He looks like he's about to have a heart attack.
Or a car wreck.
If Billy doesn't look like he's driving, consumers may not take the Jupiter Jack seriously.
I know he's not driving.
To anywhere in any car.
Don't send us, not send us.
Oh, no, no, I don't want to yet.
Sully desperately needs to reshoot more driving footage for the Jupiter Jack infomercial. So the next morning, he scrambles the crew and gets Billy back on the road to get the shots they need.
In my car, the Jupiter Jack is the only system I use because I could drive safely and talk at the same time.
With more convincing footage of Billy driving, Sully thinks they should have enough for a hit commercial.
Billy Mays here for the Jupiter Jack.
6 weeks later, the Jupiter Jack commercial finally goes live.
Hi, it's Billy.
Billy and Sully have arrived at the data center to monitor sales.
I'm driving in to see Billy and Anthony. They have some results for me on how it's going. I'm just hoping that I haven't been completely wrong the whole time, that the product does what it says, and it's a good product, and they're able to market it in a way that I never could. Wish me luck.
Hey, Jason, what's going on?
Much, how's
just
it going?
Break through security and come right in, huh?
Good to see you.
Yeah, can't hold me back.
Yeah, it's all right, awesome. How you doing? How was the trip up, all right?
It was great. A little rainy, but I made it.
Cool, I'll tell you what, we'll cut to the chase. Yeah. We tested some media, and I gotta be honest. Go, you could tell him, Billy, if you want.
Let me ask you a question. When you think of Jupiter, what do you think of?
The biggest planet.
Well, my friend, you're gonna have one of the biggest products of the year.
Home run.
Oh, my God. Really?
Yep.
No,
congratulations.
Right, we don't even have to tweak this one. We got the
I knew. You know, I always say I know, but I knew.
Look at it. He thought you were messing with it.
No.
You're not messing with me now.
No, it's for real. It's for real.
Jupiter Jack looks like a big hit with consumers. For every dollar spent on advertising, it could generate over $3 in revenue.
But I'm still not done.
As the orders roll in, manufacturing will go into full swing. If the Jupiter Jack continues to sell well, Jason Bob could make hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars from his invention, while saving lives in the process.
The most rewarding thing about this whole thing is a sense of accomplishment, a sense of the follow-through
of having an idea and seeing it all the way to the end. I didn't want to be sitting in my rocking chair when I got old and be thinking about, boy, I wish I had done all those things I had thought of.
We don't see many products that you, the minute you see them, you're like, we want to do that. And I can tell Billy, the minute he picked it up, he's like, smells like money. You know what I mean? Congratulations, man. Seriously.
I always want to say I knew, you know, but I knew. I knew it. This is what America needs. And they voted. It's a hit.